Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're diving into something that's been a challenge in the past for Angular developers, the need to break style encapsulation in certain cases with ng-d. It's been deprecated for quite some time, but there are still times where we need to use it, or at least there used to be. Now, we have modern solutions that not only replace ng-d, but can also make code cleaner and more maintainable. In this tutorial, I'll show you two approaches: using CSS custom properties and disabling view encapsulation for those special cases where custom properties won't cut it. Okay, here's the basic application we'll be using for this example. Now, in this demo, I only have a couple of components. But let's imagine that this is an app that will eventually be quite large with hundreds of different components. And this particular toolbar component will be used over and over in many different situations. Okay. Operating with that in mind, what this could mean is that we'd need default colors for these buttons that are used in most common scenarios. But we'd likely need to override these colors in certain situations. In this example here, this is one of those situations. Here, we are overriding the default colors. If we open up the style sheet for this toolbar component, here we can see the default colors for the cancel and submit buttons. The submit button is black, and the cancel button is gray. But here, they're different colors because they are overridden in the app component where this is used. Here we can see that we're using ng-deep to break the style encapsulation for this component so that we can style these buttons from this parent component. If we remove these and then save, we can see the default colors for the buttons. This is a perfect situation for CSS custom properties, so let's switch it over. First, we need to set up the buttons to use custom properties. To do this, we need to start by adding the var function. Then we can add the name for the custom property prefixed with two dashes. Let's go with cancel background. Okay, so now if we define this custom property on a parent, that value will be used. If not, it will fall back to this gray value. Okay, now let's add a custom property for our submit button. Now what happens if we remove the overrides and save? Perfect, the default colors are applied. Now we just need to provide our custom property overrides for these colors. We can add them in our rule set for the styles on the host element. All right, that's it. Now let's save and see if it works. And there we go. So not only does this eliminate the need for ng-deep, but it actually results in fewer styles, at least in this case. Custom properties are usually the first thing I go for in scenarios like this because they are simple and easy to implement. But sometimes you may find that they don't work so well and you need another solution. Let's look at an example. The other component we have here is a checkbox component. Now, I've only added this component for stylistic purposes. In this app, most of the time when we use a checkbox, we want it to look like it does here. And to pull this off, we need several styles. So there's not really a great way to do this with custom properties. And we may not want to add these as global styles because we may want a more standard checkbox style in certain scenarios. So what I've done is create this component basically as a wrapper that we can add whenever we want to opt into this style. Here we can see this component is wrapping both of the checkboxes and their associated labels. Now, we could have totally added the checkbox and label into our checkbox component, but what I've found is that you often need direct access to the input element for programming reasons, so that's why I prefer this wrapping style component for this type of thing. But this means that we need to use ng-deep, right? Actually, no. We have another option. Styles, by default in Angular, are scoped or encapsulated for each component, right? But we can actually disable this for certain components when needed. We can add the encapsulation property in our component metadata. Then we can add the view encapsulation enum from the Angular core module. This encapsulation mode can be one of three things. It can be set to emulated, which is the default, where special scoping attributes are applied to emulate the effects of the native shadow DOM. It can also be set to shadow DOM, where it actually uses the native shadow DOM to encapsulate styles. Or it can be set to none, where there will be no style encapsulation. And this is what we're going to do here. This means that the styles in this component will now be added unscoped. Essentially, they're applied just like the global styles. So we have to take extra care when doing this. Also, it means we need to make a few changes to our styles. First, we won't need ng-deep anymore because all of the styles in this style sheet are now inserted without scoping. Also, now that we have turned off our encapsulation, this host selector will no longer apply because it's not being emulated and because we have no native shadow DOM for this component. So what I like to do here is wrap these styles in the component selector instead, so they will only apply to the elements placed within it. Okay, that should be it. Let's save and find out. Nice, there it is. These styles look exactly the same, but now they no longer need ng-deep. So there's a couple of ways to effectively replace ng-deep in your projects. CSS custom properties are a flexible and efficient way to manage styles for reusable components. And for more complex cases, disabling view encapsulation can be a great alternative. All right, I hope that was helpful. Be sure to check out the channel for lots more Angular tips and tricks. Thanks for watching.